Well, guys, the day has finally come. The release of the Xbox Series X and the Xbox Series S. So, I've managed to purchase myself an Xbox Series X. So, I've decided to do you guys an Xbox Series X unboxing and also give you my first impressions and how easy it is to set up on your TV. So, let's get started. So if you want to hear the latest gaming news, tech news, reviews and comparisons, hit that subscribe button followed by the bell. So the start of the next generation consoles has finally arrived with the Xbox Series X and the Xbox Series S release. We do also have the PS5 release coming up very soon, and I'll be making another video the second that comes out. I've got one on pre-order and I'll be doing an unboxing video and testing out the features on that PS5 and giving my first impressions, just like what I'm going to be doing with this Xbox Series X that we've got here. So I picked up my Xbox Series X here in the UK from a shop called Game this morning. So we're in lockdown at the time you're watching this video. So right now, that basically means you can't really move around the country that easily right now. You can only go out to get essential things. And I think an Xbox Series X does count as an essential thing to pick up. So last week, before the lockdown began, what I had to do was I had to kind of pay off the remainder of this Xbox Series X here. And then basically there was a deal that I'd have to come into the store, the game store, and then basically pick it up. As you can see here, it was nicely done. They'd done it at the store. They had a nice like cardboard cutout at the front saying Power Your Dreams on the Xbox Series X and the Xbox Series S. And yeah, the experience was really, really good. I managed to just only queue for about 20 minutes. Obviously, there was social distancing involved. And then I managed to get myself my Xbox Series X. And then I managed to come home and start making this video for you guys. So, without further ado, let's have a quick look at the box first of all, and then we'll start doing the unboxing. So I'll bring the camera a bit closer up to the table in a minute, but first of all, let's have a look. So as you can see here, you've got the Xbox Series X here on the very, very front of it. You've got the green kind of glow coming through that kind of grill. Originally, we thought it was going to be a green light, but we found out it's just kind of just painted on in it. So we'll have a look at that a bit more further a bit later on. And then on the side here, we have a picture of the Xbox Series X along with the black controller there. The new controller was supposedly a little bit smaller than the normal Xbox One controller. So we'll have a look at that. And then on the back, you've got the famous Master Chief from Halo here. Unfortunately, he didn't get released as a launch title for the Xbox Series X or the S or even on the Xbox One. It has been delayed into 2021, what was a bit of a blow, I'll be honest with you. And but yeah, you can see here it says Power Your Dreams and gives you a bit more information there. And then on the side of it here, we've got some more information about the console and its specs and things, the ability to do 4K, 120 frames per second, and so on and so forth, and bits and pieces like that. So what I'm going to do first of all, before we bring the camera up, I'm just going to do these tags here. They've got some sticky tags. You can see here with the little arrow, we just pull it like that. Oh, nice, tough. Undo that one. And then what else we got here? We've got another one on the other side. It's got Xbox logo on it. And that one's off as well. So I'm going to put those to one side. And then we should be able to, if I'm right, start opening up the box. Ah, I'm going to have to fold it down. And I'm going to have to lift it up from the looks of it, from the very, very top. What I'll do is I'll bring the camera a little bit closer so you guys can see this, and then we'll have a look what all the bits and pieces were inside this Xbox, and then we'll connect it up to a screen and we'll check it out, how easy it is to set up. So I've just realized there's two more stickers at the bottom here when I brought the camera a little bit more closer to the table. So I'm just going to undo those. Microsoft definitely like their stickers at the moment. So we've got one there and we've just got one here as well. So just pull that down, get those right off. And there we go. Oh, top of the box just pinged open. So I'm gonna open this up and let's see what we've got. Oh wow, look at that. That is amazing. I don't know if I can just lift up the box slightly. You've literally got something that says Power Your Dreams here label, and there is the Xbox console for the first time. It's packaged up and it looks beautiful. In fact, it actually looks smaller than I thought. I'm just going to take it out of its box here if I can. It's wedged in with a lot of packaging. Definitely, I will say that. So let me just lift him up out of there. There we go. What we'll do is we'll look at the rest of the box in a moment. I'm just going to put it to one side. We'll have a look at this. I've still got a piece of packaging on here. So I'm just going to move that off and put that in the box for the time being. So you can see here it says power your dreams. And I can tell you right now, this is quite heavy. It's definitely a heavy box. So I'm just going to remove that cardboard off, that nice sleeve that they've given us. So it says power your dreams. And let's have a look at the Xbox Series X tower for the first time. Let's have a look. So I'm just going to open that off. And we're just going to slide this out for the first time. And wow, look at that, guys. There is the Xbox Series X console. I'll move it a bit more closer for you guys to see there. Sorry, I can't get it in the right of the view. But that is a beast. That is a tower. Supposedly the PS5 is even bigger than this. So yeah, this is unbelievable. You can see there the green. You can see it coming through there. So yeah, that is absolutely amazing. Let's just turn it around to the side. A very, very kind of plain design. And then if we turn it round to the back now, we've got all the different ports down here. We've got the HDMI, we've got the USB 3.0 ports, and we've also got HDMI and power. And then we've also got that expansion slot for those Seagate expansion cards to increase your storage in the back of it. And they're not just released just yet, but yeah, they should be coming out soon. So you get 1 terabyte of storage on this. But yeah, the tower looks absolutely phenomenal, actually. And then what you can also do is that you can turn it on its side and put it down like that and have it like that if you wish. You can have kind of a long tower. There are rubber grips there, as you can see on the bottom, to do that if you want it sideways. So yeah, that is really, really cool. It's a nice design, very, very box design, and very relevant for Xbox. So yeah, let's put that to one side for the moment. So I'm just going to stick him up here for the moment. Let's see what else we got inside that box. So I'm just going to bring the box back up to you guys. So like I said, we had lots and lots of packaging, bits and pieces. I'm just going to take those out as well. We've got a card here at the bottom of the box. And basically it's just a quick little guide box. So it's kind of telling me here that I need to download the Xbox app to set up the Xbox. It works on Android, and it also works on iOS as well. And there's a QR code that you can scan there to download the app if you wish as well. It tells you how to put the batteries in your controller and set up and do the syncing with the controller as well. And it tells you about all the different ports and everything and how to put batteries in and everything like that. So yeah, that is really, really cool. Let's see then what's in this sleeve then at the back here. I'm guessing this is where our controller is being stored and everything else. Oh, does it come out? Oh, this bit actually comes as a separate box. In fact, I'll tell you what I'm going to do. I'm going to take that out, move the Xbox big box out of the way so we can open up this one. So yeah, oh, it's very, very nice inside here. So we have here, first of all, the controller with some packaging as well. So let's just open you up. I can definitely tell you guys this controller is smaller. I can tell that is smaller straight away. But yeah, let's have a look. Let's get you out. And wow, yeah, that's nice, that is. Now, I don't know if you can tell here, but I can tell you straight away, the black here is a different type of black to the Xbox one. So it might look like I'm shining too much light on this Xbox controller. And you can tell that it's not as black as an Xbox one, and it isn't. It's actually slightly shade lighter, but it does feel nice. You've got some really nice grips here on the side and everything. And that is definitely smaller than that. That definitely, wow, my hand's just glued straight in. That is really comfortable. I really like the feel of that, actually. Yeah, that is perfect. I know they say I haven't changed the controller, like the PS5 has changed their design, but that just feels so much nicer. This feels longer in my hand. It just feels much more comfortable and everything. Yes, I'm really, really impressed with that. That is a really nice controller. You've got a USB-C at the top, so we get a battery pack in there and we can charge it up, and we've got the sync button. So yeah, let's just put that to one side for one moment. Let's see what else we've got in here. So for the first time ever, the first Xbox console So the like the one that they bring out first of all, so like an Xbox Original, Xbox 360, and Xbox One. We do not have a power brick. Yay! The power supply is built into the console. So you'll know what I'm talking about if you've owned an original Xbox, the original Xbox 360, the Ring of Death Xbox 360 as it's known, and if you've owned the original Xbox One console, they all came with power bricks. This one doesn't, and it's about time too, so that's really, really good. So I'm going to put that to one side as well. And then we've also got a HDMI cable, and I'd recommend you guys to use this HDMI cable if you've got a 4K TV, what can support 120Hz refresh rate for 120 frames per second, because this HDMI cable can do that. It's an ultra high speed cable. So make sure you definitely use the cable supplied, because if you want to get that full on experience, because otherwise if you use a kind of a standard cable that you bought from a cheap shop down the road for only a couple of dollars or a couple of pounds where I'm from, you probably won't get that full on 120Hz and that full really good display. So definitely use the cable supplied. Let's see what else we've got inside this box here. So we just have a guide as well. It's a product warranty and bits and pieces and all the blah, blah, blah sort of stuff. So in summary, what you get inside the box, apart from all the paperwork and everything, you get the actual Xbox console, you get that lovely new controller, you also get the power supply, and you get a HDMI cable as well. So there's only one thing we need to do now, and that is set it up and give it a test run. What I'm really excited to do for the first time. I've downloaded the app onto my phone, the Xbox app, so hopefully it should be an easy setup, but I bet the Xbox has got a day one update. But we will see in the mo, so let's connect it up. So I've wired up my Xbox Series X here. It's all ready to go now. It's all plugged into my 4K monitor that I have here. I've got some speakers as well connected up because my monitor doesn't have it built in. I will be connecting it to my home system later, but I just wanted to show you guys here first of all. So without further ado, let's power on this Xbox for the first time. And I've got my Xbox app ready here. I know because it said in the piece of paper to download it. I've already had the app, so we're going to set it up Xbox through the app here. It's going to be much easier than clicking around, typing in my email address and password and getting all my settings back that way. So let's power it on then for the first time. I'll just switch my iPad around here. I'll just find the button there. Let's turn it on. So that's the same sound on there. Let's see then if we get different sound on the TV, on the monitor. Oh, there we go. That's just my monitor kicking in there. There we go, as you can see. So it's just starting up. Oh, that was quick. That was super quick, that was. So I've got the app and it's telling me to put my code in. So what I'm just going to do quickly on here, you probably can't see it, there is an ability to connect to a console. There's a console button menu, say here, set up a console, and then you can click set up a new console. What I'm just doing here, and it says please enter those characters I see on the screen. So I'm just going to put those in right now. Let's have a look. And there we go, I've entered it. I'm going to connect to the console. And it says here on my screen, I don't know if you can see this, if I want to join it. So I'm just joining the network right now, setting it up. I'm not sure you can see this very clearly, but it's quite easy on the app to do. So it's just going to do that. It says, would I like to connect to my device? Yeah. Oh, it says, please make sure you enter the code matches and then try again. I'm sure I've got the code right. I do have it connected correctly. Let's just try that again. Maybe it was just a glitch. There we go. Let's see if it connects now. And there we go, it worked there, second time. I don't know what happened there. So it's connected with the console, I'm gonna click next. And then it's giving me all the settings. So I live, which country I live in, what language, it all set up fine. It's also gonna tell me which Wi-Fi I'd like to connect to. So I'm just gonna put my Wi-Fi password in. This is so much easier, guys, than being able to do this on the screen and clicking around all over the place. It's a right pain in the backside, I'll say that now. So there we go, she's connecting my console to the Wi-Fi, it says. This reminds me of Glass, what came out on the Xbox 360. It was the ability to have a second screen. It didn't really kick off, but I like this with the setup. There we go, we connect to the Wi-Fi. And it's just moving on ahead now in the process. Ah, look at that, guys. There's an update, 775 megabytes or megabits. It says it won't take too long. I've got a 370 megabit connection, so really, it shouldn't take that long at all. But while that's downloading, it's given me a few options here. Look at that, we're at 10% already on the screen. What would I like to do? I'd like to set it up as instant on, so I can set it up straight away at work. It's asking me if I'd like to put my barriers sign in. I'm just going to do this on my app here. So I'm going to say it's going to ask for my key. And it's asking me if I'd like to keep my apps up today while this is downloading. I like it that this is downloading and updating and it's still going on with the setup. That's really, really good. Would I like to have turn on remote features? Yes, I would. Okay, and it says, just a moment, we're just setting things up for you. This will just take a few more seconds, if you can see that. I'm really glad I actually did this on my iPad, not my phone, because you wouldn't have for me up to see a thing here. But I know it's quite difficult. You're just going to have to trust me. This is what the setup says. Probably it's going to wait now for the actual console to finish updating. So what we'll do is we'll just let this run to the end to update. And then when something appears either on the TV or either updates on my actual iPad here, we'll continue on. Let's just fast forward a bit here then. So the Xbox has now updated, as you can see. And it says here, if I want to continue on, please resume on the app. And it says here I need to sign in now with my Xbox profile on the app. So that's what I'm just going to do now quickly, guys. I'm just going to sign in quickly. Shouldn't take too long. Now hopefully, because it's using my app, what I'm already signed into, it should just do everything automatically. It's also asking me to give my console a name. So I'm going to call it the Living Room Xbox, because that's where it's going to live. Let's just continue on. There's a few other settings here of like Xbox info and offers. Would they like me to send that? I'd rather not. I find out about tech news and YouTube channels and things like that. And then this is brilliant as well. It's also telling me I can copy my data from another Xbox if I want to. So what I have here, I've got an Xbox that was backed up. So I'm just going to copy that over now. So yep. That's now starting. And it says we're all done now. So it's just going to finish now. So I don't know if the screen is going to continue updating or whatnot. But it says here it's updating on my app. And then when it's all finished, we'll get to the home screen for the first time, guys. Well, there we go, guys. We're now at the Xbox Series X home screen. Now, if you own an Xbox at the moment, you'll know this looks absolutely identical to an Xbox One, Xbox One S, One X, or anything like that. And even the Xbox Series X will look identical to this Series S, or Series X, sorry, I've got here. So why Microsoft have done this, it's all part of their plan for the next generation. The way how Xbox have seen to do this is a bit like getting a computer. If you bought a computer, say, 5 years ago, with Windows 10 on it, and you had the best specs then, and now 5 years later, those specs are kind of dying out, you buy yourself a new computer, and you get yourself the next level of specs in it, but you're still running Windows 10 on that computer. And the interface and the display and everything and all your games all still run, but they just look much better. That is the purpose of an Xbox Series X in console form. It's like an Xbox One, but it gives you that next level of graphics and details and speed and everything like that while keeping the same interface that you see here. Well then guys, let's try a game now inside the Xbox Series X. So today, the Xbox Series X has launched on November the 10th, but at the same time as well, we've got Assassin's Creed Valhalla, if I'm saying that correctly, forgive me if I'm not. And I bought a copy of this for the next generation. And as you can see here, it says it's for Xbox One. It also says it's for the Xbox Series X as well. And you've also got the Series X label in the corner here to say it's enhanced for it. So I'm just going to open this up and I'm going to pop it inside. So we've got some bits and pieces inside here. I've got some extra bits and codes to redeem later on. So I'm just going to get the disc in. I'm just going to pop that in, put it the right way around. In it goes. By the way, the Xbox is really quite quiet. I would actually say it sounds quieter than my Xbox One. I know the CD drive, DVD drive, Blu-ray drive, whatever you want to call it, it's booting up now. But overall, it's not that loud. But yeah, so the disc is now spinning and it's just going to update. So if we just go into my apps and games, and then if we go into the queue here, there we go. So, oh, it says there is an upgrade, a 46.4 gigabyte upgrade on the game. Of course there is. And this is probably the Xbox Series X enhanced version. So I'm going to click upgrade and we're going to leave that. And what it's doing now, it's basically putting the main physical game on, and then what's going on the internet in the background, it's downloading the game. So I'm going to leave this run now. As you can see, it's 41.2 gigabytes. So it's going to take some time to install from the disk and also download from the internet. Look at that, just to show you guys. It's only going to install 620 megabytes of the disk. This is a Blu-ray disk. 620 megabytes is a CD disk back in the day. That's nothing. It's getting most of the stuff from the actual internet. Basically, all the disk has done is just given like a code. That's all the disk is. It's just basically, yes, you've got access to the game. And then the Xbox is downloading the full game from the internet in the full Xbox Series X mode with all the ray tracing and 4K, 120 frames per second, whatever's been enhanced for this game, it is doing that. So as you can imagine, I'm not going to leave this run, guys, because it's going to take forever. Well, actually, to be honest, it's doing it quite well. I'm at 100. Well, was that 100 megabytes per second just there a minute ago? But it's saying it's going to take about 20 minutes or so. Well, we'll leave this run and we'll catch up soon. So the game is now all installed and everything. So I'm just opening it up now for the first time and see how quickly this loads up. So there's a few bit of a disclaimer there. And we've got Ubisoft. That's nice and quick as well. It's normally after this next scene then, see how quickly it takes to load up to the main menu. There we go, it's telling me, see this icon? Save the game, it's saving. Wow, that was quick. Let's just go into it then. Let's start a new thing, it's just checking, it's just telling me to come back. I've got benefits, I'm going to have a look a bit later on because I want to get on with the game. So what we're going to do is we're going to start a new game. Just to set this up, just to set everything easy just to start with. It's probably going to tell me to calibrate the screen now, maybe. Or not. We'll see. But that looks brilliant. Well, I can't show too much of this game, I'll be deadly honest, because otherwise I'll get copyright infringement from YouTube, so I'll just have to show you that. But you could see it loaded really, really quickly. And to be honest, you can hear the Xbox whirring, I don't know if you can, it's really, really quiet. And we have already loaded up the game. I know I haven't got the full specs and graphics running, everything like that right now, but I will be doing another review later on this channel to show you a bit more about how older games work as well as the newer games. But I just wanted to show you guys, first of all, my first impressions of the Xbox. And I'll be honest, I think it's really, really good. For the first time, I actually think Xbox have got this right with their actual console. I'm not talking about exclusives, I'm talking about the console itself. We don't have a stupid power brick this time. We don't have this kind of cheap kind of plastic sort of thing. The design is not as bad as I thought, actually. I thought it was going to be a massive tower. It's been made it out to be like that. But it's not actually that bad, and it will fit underneath my TV cabinet, I'm quite sure. Either this way up or lying down. It's not as bad. And it's really, really quiet. And the controller just feels brilliant in my hand. It feels really, really nice. I'm really impressed with it. So my first impressions of getting everything set up and working have been fantastic. It's been a dream to do that. So yeah, I think it's really good. So like I said, guys, I will be making another video later on my channel to talk a bit more about the actual games experience and a few of the other features what you get with the Xbox Series X. Well guys, though, I'm going to wrap up this video for now. So if you have enjoyed watching this unboxing and first impressions, please do press the like button. And at the same time, guys, if you want to hear the latest news on gaming news, tech news, reviews and comparisons, please do hit that subscribe button followed by the bell. Until next time, guys, I'll see you soon.